also when Noah built the ark. I said, beginning. He started from the beginning.
Yes.
Amen. So, Genesis is not the Old Testament. Genesis is the book of the beginning. The Old Testament begins with Exodus. Not with Genesis. So Jesus was in the beginning. Where he was, Jesus. Let me take my time. Jesus was no ark. And not only that, missionary, Jesus was Abraham's sacrificial lamb.
Yes, he was.
That's why God did not allow Abraham to kill Isaac. Get what I'm saying? Because Isaac of no value to God.
Amen.
Isaac identified all of us.
Yes.
That's why Isaac didn't could not die, because it is Christ that must die.
Yes.
If Isaac did die, it would have changed nothing, Sister Philip. Because Isaac represent you, Isaac represent me. That's why Jesus himself had to prepare himself a sacrificial lamb. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Say, neighbor, are your eyes open? Say, are your eyes open? That's why Isaac could not die, because Isaac was not the Christ. And they come close to the Christ because the Old Testament saints, they could not see Christ. So they talk like this. Unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall see the name. But they could not. The name of Jesus could, it was not yet revealed. So they come say the name. You know what I'm saying? The name of Jesus was concealed. So now Isaiah is pointing to Christ. He says that his name shall be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father. That's his name. But the name that God says in Philippians chapter 2 and verse 9, Paul said, God hath highly exalted him and given a name above. See, that's why a person can't be saved, because they believe in God. The only way you can be saved, you got to believe in Jesus. Because Jesus said, I am the way. You hear that? I am the way. This is somebody that has supreme power that is going to tell you that I am the way. And not only the way, I am the truth. I am the way and the truth. And no man can come to the Father but by me. So nobody can know who God is without knowing Jesus. Why? Because God is an invisible God. You can never see him. That's why the Bible says no man never seen God except the only begotten Son of God. Why? Because Jesus Christ is the very express image of this invisible God. Hallelujah. I always like to talk to somebody. I said Jesus is the very express image of God. So when you know Jesus, you know the Father. You remember in St. John chapter 14, God, they asked a question. God, Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, that it may, and that it may satisfy me. But Jesus said, how long you been with me, and I've not known the Father. Come on, somebody. We in church and don't know who Jesus is. Been saved 20 years. I'm still talking about Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You need a deliverance. Hallelujah. That's why he's not moving. That's why things are happening. Because the devil is not afraid of the Father. The devil is not afraid of the Son. He is not afraid of the Holy Ghost. But he is afraid of Jesus. It is in that name that salvation is given. It is in that name that one has been delivered and delivered and set free. It is in that name that one becomes the instrument of God. It is in that name, our God, that one received the empowerment of the Holy Ghost. Jesus was God. In other words, God pressed down in Jesus. Come into a physical realm, limit himself from certain things that has been God. In other words, Jesus was God pressed down in him. The God of the creation, but yet becomes the Son of redemption. Not only the son of the redemption, but the son of regeneration. That's the Holy Ghost. He regenerates us. He repowers us. Hallelujah, by the Holy Ghost. Glory be to God. That's why when one understands that Jesus is God, you rest. The church will never enter into their rest except they understand who Jesus Christ is. It's an identity crisis where you're trying to know who Jesus is. You're searching to know who Jesus is. But Jesus Christ is God.
Yes, yes.
Let's go to Colossians. Colossians 2 and verse 9. Colossians 2 and verse 9. Say, Jesus is God.
Jesus is God.
Let's ask your neighbor. Let's ask to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, do you believe that Jesus Christ is God? Now what you want to your neighbor? Give him an honest answer.
Jesus Christ is God.
Not trying to be God. Or not one of the gods.
He is God.
But he is God. He's the supreme God. There's no authority that is higher than the authority that Jesus Christ has. What Paul say? What Paul said. Yes, Colossians chapter 2, verse 9.
Who in him dwell all the fullness of the Godhead.
You hear that? In who? In who? In him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead. What? What that mean? In physical flesh. That means God himself was pressed down in Jesus. Because in him dwelled all the fullness. With all, the all included the Godhead. The Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, all was in Jesus. All was in Jesus. All was in Jesus because Jesus Christ was God. Amen. He was God. He was the God at the beginning. He's the God that said, let there be light, and there was light. Amen. He was the Word. Because the Bible says in John chapter 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And in verse 14, he says, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory as like unto the what? Glory of the God and of the Father, that full with grace and truth. Jesus was the embodiment of God. Jesus was an embodiment of God because no one can see God's face because God is invisible. So when you look at Jesus, you see the face of God.
Yes, hallelujah.
That's why, amen. That's why the Bible says, no man have seen God at any time.
Amen.
Because how can you see something that invisible? That means you have no face. But I can see Jesus. When you see Jesus, you see God. When he told Philip, he said, Philip, if you have seen me, you have seen the Father. Why then you said that I must show you the Father? No, he not. Say that word, Jesus. Do you know that I'm the embodiment of the Father? I'm the invisible See, the Father is invisible God, but now I am this invisible God in physical appearance. Now you can see me. You can see me now. You can see me now. Amen. You can see me now. Because you see Jesus, you see God. Amen. Hallelujah. I said, you see Jesus, you see God. So stop telling, Lord, reveal yourself to me. What do you mean, Lord, reveal yourself to me? That means you're still struggling with an identity crisis, because if you don't know who Jesus is, then you don't know who you is. That's why we have folks as unstable in the church. Unstable. You cannot be stable when you don't know who you is and what you're supposed to be doing. But when you know who you is, you are stable and you will carry it out.
Amen.
You will do it. Hallelujah. Amen. We will not allow ourselves to be unstable because we don't know who Jesus is. Knowing about church ain't enough. Because most of us, and you can tell too, you can tell. Because for example, my wife, when you know, the Bible said, he, amen.